we've seen so far a little bit of fog this morning, and that will be an issue for some for the next hour or two. But really, today is not going to be all that problematic. Going into tonight and early tomorrow, though, that's our next severe weather system that's going to come through. And we are talking the potential for gusty straight line winds and spin up tornadoes as well, although the better threat for that will be further to the north. It's been cloudy and rainy for about the last day, but today we will finally get a break from the clouds and the rain. And long about 9 o'clock, we'll start to see some peaks of sunshine. Temperatures too, warming up at that point. 64 will be 73 by lunchtime, and 78 today will be our high. It's also going to be breezy with wind coming from the southeast. That will be adding moisture back into the atmosphere, which is essentially energy. So even though we'll see a few showers through 4 o'clock, the better storm potential is coming in tonight as we continue to pull up this wind from the southeast. We also have a dip in the jet stream and a cold front coming in from the west. All of those things will be lining up nicely today to bring the chance for strong to severe storms overnight. The greatest threat, especially for tornadoes, is going to be to the north and east for a lot of North Mississippi and even into Alabama and Tennessee. That's not to say, especially for some of our northern counties, that the threat there for a spin-up tornado would be slightly higher. That's where the best energy is going to be, and it will be early on into this time frame, which is starting 11 o'clock or midnight or so. The further south the line of storm gets, the less energy there will be, so there is the chance that the storms will weaken a little bit, although still for most of the area from midnight through around 7 o'clock in the morning, there is the chance for those gusty straight line winds or spin up tornadoes. Predictor Plus, though, for today shows a quiet day. You'll see some of these showers rolling up from the south, but really nothing too problematic until we get to about midnight. That's when this line of thunderstorms is expected to move in with that cold front. You can see it's starting to roll in here right about midnight. You can also see the worst of it looks to be just to our north and east, but this is the time frame that we would have to be starting to worry about the gusty winds along with the potential for the spin-up tornadoes. Going forward into time, this is early, early tomorrow morning. You can see the worst of it continues to stay to our north and east. We're still likely to be getting some strong or even severe storms at this point in time, but the further south we go with this system, it's going to be losing energy. And probably by 5 or 6 o'clock in the morning, most of those storms are going to be just regular run-of-the-mill thunderstorms, maybe with brief gusty winds. But then by 7 o'clock, everything is all gone, and you can head out to work or school or to the polls and not have to worry about any rain. And then into tomorrow, once this front passes through, we'll dry out briefly. Still going to be really warm, though. There's not a lot of cold air back behind this front. And because the upper atmosphere is still going to be bringing in some moisture, we'll keep the chance for a few showers and storms around through Thursday, and it will remain quite warm. Into Friday, though, and through the weekend, there will be a huge cool down. Mornings will be into the 30s and 40s, afternoons with full sunshine, even only up into the 50s. But in terms of severe weather this week, the biggest event that we have will be tonight through early tomorrow morning.